Hey YouTube, this is Steve Jones. We're going to be talking about James chapter 1, 1 through 4. James, a bondservant of God and the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad, greetings. My brothers, consider it all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. But let patience have its perfect work, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing. Okay, James, he first identifies himself as a bondservant of God and the Lord Jesus Christ. Okay, a bondservant is a little bit different than a typical servant. A servant would be forced to do whatever his master said. A bond servant is a voluntary role. If you read, I think it's probably Leviticus, can go in there and they'd give the details of a bond servant. You were done with your normal serving. You would have the option to stay with your master for a lifetime. And you'd take your ear, you'd put it up on the doorpost, they'd pierce it, and that'd be like your ID card there, saying that I'm a bondservant. Okay, so James, he's expressing his heart here to voluntarily be a slave, to voluntarily give his life to the Lord for whatever God would have him do. Because he loves his master and he knows that his master will take awesome care of him. As bondservants often, that's the reason why they were bondservants. It's because their master was so awesome. He's writing here to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad. Okay, the 12 tribes, he could have been writing to Jewish Christians, believers in Christ who practice Judaism. Or he could be speaking allegorically of the church, the family of God that's scattered abroad. It's kind of neat because here I am on YouTube, hopefully speaking to many different places and people, and kind of feel like that'd be my greeting to all the people scattered abroad, the YouTubes. All right. Verse 2, very, very provocative verse. He says, brothers, consider it joy, all joy. Some versions say pure joy. Consider it pure joy when you face trials of many different kinds or various trials. There's many various trials that we can face. Trials could mean hardship, loss of family, loss of a job, financial crisis. It could be a temptation, a struggle, an addiction that is haunting you and continues to test you or try you. Now, James is saying that we should consider this a joyful moment. And that's just counterintuitive, difficult, seems impossible. But as we continue reading, we see that it's really not. It's a matter of having the right knowledge. He goes on talking about this knowledge. He says knowing. Okay, that you can know something about the trials you're in, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. Okay, so you have this knowing. You know. You have faith as you're going through a trial. Okay, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. So there's a testing going on. Oftentimes we're so focused on the trial, we don't see the bigger picture. We don't see that this is a test, that God is above and beyond our circumstances, wanting to put our faith on in a test. He's wanting to, it says, produce patience. The word patience can also be long-suffering or steadfastness. This idea of becoming stronger, growing a stronger backbone. You've heard about possibly the persecuted church in China. They say, don't pray that our persecution would go away. Don't pray that our problems would flee, but pray that we would have a stronger back to endure them. And I think we need to realize that that these trials are good, that all things happen for the good of those who love God and are called according to His purpose. So God is doing something here, and we can know that. That these trials, that maybe you're going through a trial right now, or you just went through one, or you might have one right around the corner. And it's important to know that God is using this to test your faith, but He's also using it to strengthen you, to give you the ability to be strong. He says, let patience have its perfect work, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing. So let this play out, he's saying. Have joy. Let it play out. Have joy. Be joyful. Rejoice, he's saying. Rejoice in your salvation. Rejoice in God through this trial. Because as it progresses, there's going to be this perfecting. Okay, we know this side of heaven, we're not going to be perfect, morally perfect and righteous in all we do. But this perfection is speaking more of a wholeness, a completeness, or a spiritual maturity that's going to happen. And that's what trials do, is they mature you in your faith. They help you to grow up spiritually. And so we can thank God and praise God and rejoice and have joy, even in the hardest of times. And I'm not saying not to grieve or not to mourn, but true joy really is that inner a thing that we can have that goes beyond our circumstances. He says, perfect and complete, lacking nothing. He says lacking nothing because as you mature and progress in your faith, those who have stood the test of time and stood the test of many trials, they don't worry. They don't have fear about tomorrow. They know that God is going to be there. They know that God is going to provide for them. So as you're going through these trials, you know that you're going to be at a place where you lack absolutely nothing. You have total faith. You have total trust that God is bigger and beyond, and you are mighty and victorious in battle. Okay, God is sending us through a battle that we can fight and that we can have joy in. And so maybe you're in that trial now and you're struggling, or maybe you're battling and you're questioning things. James is just reaffirming his brothers, and I want to reaffirm you, that God is doing a greater thing. He's doing a bigger thing. And to have a joy in the middle of it. Because He's working on you. He's going to finish what He started. And He's going to perfect what He began. So that's all I have to share for James. I love you guys. Get in contact with me, write comments, let me know what you think. Hopefully if you find this on Facebook, I can catch up with some of you. And take care. God bless.